And I think we are live again. Let me just verify that we are live. We should be live. Hi guys, we are joining with the game between Sandy and Henry. Similar to the previous team, we have C1 versus Baltic Seas. Players are playing Tyrell Fate Militant. I expect to see a lot of 7 cards and the Sparrow showing their ugly hands. Versus Targaryen Valyrian Steel, we haven't seen this up to this point. It is one of the latest agenda made by Corey. 75 card decks, you can have each attachment one in only one copy of it, and when you play an attachment you get a gold or draw card up to 3 times per round, and during the and as an action you can use your faction care to ambush an attachment into play. Opening plots we have at the gates for both players. For the Tyrell, at the gates found Gates of the Gods. For the Targaryen player, we found Dragon Gate. I assume we will draw a lot of cards, similar to Gates of the Gods in this game. Sandy's setup was, I believe, 2 cards in Shadow, Gates of the Moon and Right. And the setup for the Henry was Stormcrows, Littlefinger, Illyrio Estate and Plaza of Pride. We are currently in the German marshalling. We have Jogo with added Warrior's Braid. That gives him renown, and when he wins a military challenge he gets a belt tokens. From the agenda reaction he drew a card. I will just have a look at the decks and I will join you guys in the chat in a second. So, few words for the deck. Sandy's deck until they finish their marshalling. Let's hope. Sandy's deck is really focused, looks like again around the Sparrows. We have left and right, 3 copies of which will probably take care of defense, and devoted free riders to stop Econ from the in the challenges phase. Passive power engine, we have Old Town, Fate's Decree to stop shenanigans, the Bane of my existence, figuring out what is the restricted card in most of the uncommon decks that we see. Andy, what's your restricted card, for God's sake? I have no idea. I'm better at Tyrell, guys, sorry about that. Oh, Flea Bottom. So, Sandy is on the Flea Bottom. And his opponent is playing Valyrian Steel, which is... I'm very happy to see the new agendas getting some love. With their several Valyrian Steel agendas, several few white books shown here and there. So for Henry, we have restricted cards. I assume again Flea Bottom, yes. And he's running 17 different attachments. We have this by the guard, which could be helpful time Beggar King. And other than that, it's a complete Dothraki package looking at the list. 3 times Missandei, Kotu, Black Market Merchant to find the necessary attachment. So you're currently in the challenges phase. Henry is going first with the military challenge for 6 with the Stormcrows and Jogo, and Jogo was 10th afterwards with Missandei. And Missandei came into play. From Sandy's side we have right duped and Skimming Septon. I assume we will see this guy a lot during this game. And Knight of the Hollow Hill, one of the latest cards that came around, or it's but just now starting to see more and more play. It allows us to search the top 10 cards for non-wild character in the dominance phase. A little bit slow, but that card draw is safe from Intrigue Claim and other shenanigans in the following phase. Maybe even Lannister will not be able to get to those cards. We next challenge we have Intrigue, which Sandy was, then it was worth to discard Poison Coin with Sandy. And I wonder if he'll do a third challenge now for the Renown. Jogo. But that will leave him vulnerable to the military with right. He decided to pass challenges, and we see now an entry challenge with the Skimming Septon, which I assume Littlefinger will oppose. Right. Something that can happen now is the Septon go back to the deck, back to hand for 2 gold, and that leaves Sandy with enough gold for Sparrows and Unexpected Guile. Something we've seen quite common lately. Oh, we have True Diplomat. Maybe he was... When did the Warrior Bread give... Here the information is a bit misleading. Jogo is on strength, is with additional strength only when he is attacking. I'm not sure why now he is at full strength. Warrior Bread... Oh, it gives one straight. For each build token. Okay, so that's a constant. Going to Dominos. And he took the power challenge. Dominos will be for Henry. You have to win. Yeah. Yes, Sandy missed the trigger on the entry challenge. Oh no, yeah, so he didn't want. Sandy being Sandy. And we have Seized by the Guard ambushed in the dominance phase. And he drew a card from that. With the later agendas, I assume we'll see this card more and more often. Unfortunately, he wasn't able to bestow it, so it will drop off immediately next phase. But that stopped Sandy for finding barrels. Surprisingly, let's see if Sandy is selling his favorite card in the face of Old Breaker. Old Keeper, sorry. Not a single Old Keeper in the deck. What is this? This doesn't look like Sandy's deck. Turn 2. What? We have exchange of information. Like Sandy is searching for all his tools. Because this is basically a combo deck. And on the other hand, we have return on the field. Return to the field. Looks like Henry was expecting immediate reset, but I expect we won't see that very often since the Fate Militant can control very efficiently the power. Totals and slow down the game. Now back to chat. So Henry decided not to trigger a return to the field, and let's see what we have revealed for Sandy's exchange information. We have left, Old Tommy Formal, another skin acceptance that was on the top of the deck. Emissary of Hightower, Gates of the Gods, Red Wine Straits, Devoted Freerider. Looks like you get only 2 cards from this because there is only one location and everything else is characters. In these kind of situations, depending on the economy of the opponent, I usually give them the most expensive cards. I know he will not give him left for sure, but other than that, oh, there is Fate Decree here to get the cards. Other than that, Expert Gate of the Gods, Devoted Free Rider, which is the most innocent of them all. Oh, Lazy Leo. Maybe because there's still no events and he's not 7 character. But returning all the events that we expect to see at some point, rapidly playing. We'll see if this will come back to bite Henry. This time we have Sandy as the first player, so let's see how it will actually go. As we mentioned, this by the guard has fallen off due to the first reaction. Sandy used his red white strain that was given to him earlier, and Gates of the Gods came into play. This is possible thanks to the previous FAQ rating. We were up to that point, we were never able to put a duplicate on our limited location and play a limited location. That's a good addition to those factions that have a limited unique location, which are only Tyrell, Lannister and Night's Watch, but we don't talk about that one. And of course everyone runs Gates of the Moon. like Sandy Drew left. Now he has a very stable defense at his end. And he passes Arsenic with gold. Again, this is another teaming septum, Sparrow, Septum Guile, but Nenigans. Our Targaryen player, we have the third Dragon Gate, which for now will stay, will not be able to draw cards from them, but I assume that will change. And he keeps his marshalling. Interesting. This is the first time for me seeing Valyrian still in play, so I'm not very familiar what all the tricks and all the implementations there are. I assume all of us, when the agenda came, went to their favorite faction, look at all the attachments that are there, what they could do with them. Interesting for the Targaryen in that regard is that all their attachments are, have very specific conditions, with few exceptions. Most of them want either a Dothraki character or a lady. But this looks like we focus more on diversity. Currently in the challenges phase. So Sandy name used a decree to name Aegon, stopping him coming into play if the card in shadow is Aegon. He has their Gate of the Gods, their limited location from the cycle, or the 7, which is very key for all these matchups. Challenge. Scheme acceptance and then another scheme acceptance coming to remove from the challenge. With the shrewd diplomat, sorry about that. Take some time for the server, although the connection is stable. Always forget. And Sandy plays the other card that was left in the shadow, which was the poison coin for him to poison Jogo. The diplomat has both ambush and shadow. One of those very versatile characters. A minor team in Tyrell. And after that, he finishes it. We have a military with Jogo, full strength. And Henry's trying to ambush Crown of God, I assume, for left and right, but there are no attachments except weapon. So some of the diplomats have to... Yep. ending diplomat. Got kinked. Official turn. Here Sandy will be able to defend the military challenge to preserve his board a little bit. And on we have Jack Market Merchant come out from Shadows to fetch an attachment, and he fetched the little bird for the turn crows. We are still in the challenge. Jogo. Sandy, you defend it easily. I assume Henry was looking for attachment that gives additional. And there are a few of them in the Targaryen pool. Next, if an intrigue challenge would Stormcrow for got lazy Leo, easy come, easy go. Challenge was opposed, of course, with left and right. And then merchant. Port again. And we will just get him. And the fade. At the point. Henry's over reserve. I'm surprised he decided not to draw the turn, but maybe he values the economy more. I think he could have used at least one of the gates. Quality over quantity. Sandy is within his reserve of 8. And we have Henry discarded Crossroad. Pulling the strings. So Sandy is looking to play, I assume, at the gate. Opponent. Find the economy. Oh, he's using return to the field. Interesting. So maybe he has flip bottom in hand already. So that will allow him to use the shrewd diplomat instead of being stuck into on the field. Goat in a card draw. And from the Targaryen player we have Time of Plenty. A plot that was used mostly before, but now it's seeing less and less play in the face of the gates. Targaryen player Marshall Strong Belvas on the stone. It allows him to save a unique character from dying. And we have the Everybody stands Xiaomi. Which he can win the game alone without almost any problems once he switches all the attachments. Targaryen is famous for being able to discard cards a lot, so let's see if Barristan will be able to. So for those that seen him for the first time, once he came with the Lannister block back in the day, once he wins a challenge in which he is participating, if you have your cards in your hand and opponent, he can stand, and there is no limit. You can go in all challenges on offense and defense. We've seen in several melee games, that's where he's more frequently used. Not that common in the Joust games. Sandy side, we have four fellows, Begging Brother, finally he has a 7 card on the field, and immediate bestow 3 on the Begging Brother. Looks like both players are still having troubles finding 3 bottom, which makes their deck a lot more consistent. And they also play Dole Town, which is his passive power game and draw engine at the same time. Did Sandy use Hollow Hill last turn? Let's go back and see. Did he miss to use it? Ancient Dominance. Oh, he used it. Find Old Billy Bone. Okay. We have a big military challenge with Elvis and Barristan only for 8, and can reuse Plaza of Pride to send the Barristan Xiaomi discarding Black Market Merchant. Looks like this turn he will not go under the to be with fewer cards than Sandy, because he managed to mark quite a lot. I wonder if you'll see just an opposed challenge and leave it. Bell token for Barristan. But that's their fate, and so, and occasionally to gain a power. Occasionally. Unfortunately, now for the next challenges, I think even if he wants to do something, he'll have to or commit a bit with at least two characters, which may leave him open to counterattack and begging bother getting that power from the card. One character, figuring the agenda for the first time. We have an opposed power challenge with left. There is continuing with the challenges. No. He passes challenges. That sounds reasonable. Curious what Sandy will use for the military challenge, left or right. Challenge he values more than afterwards. I think I would do it with right, which gives me the two power icons to be able to get past Miss Sandy and Little Finger. That's definitely how he puts it. On the post military challenge. Angle. That reduces the strength during challenges of the character, and here we'll see a full defense. Can reuse Valyrian Steel to draw again cards. Looks like the reaction to draw cards is enough to warrant the drawback of the deck for being 75 cards. Sandy used Ho-Hue and found poor fellows. Dale knew Dowtown but missed and revealed Flea Bottom, but for the next turn he knows that he had that card to culminate him. This card pile currently is not very stacked, but he has True Diplomat there, Lazy Leo, which will miss the trigger, but more importantly he has a Dupe of Right to allow him infinite flame. I wonder if we'll see a reset now. Garen player, that would be very unlikely. Next games I'll try to have the plots in front of me so I can monitor both chat and the games, and I'll be able maybe to do a little bit more predictive. See what the plot was, but who likes. Yep, Sandy chose to power and Henry played fortified position, so both ports will be clean. Interesting choice of fortified position in this. In this case, although Devour was not very likely to happen considering the Strong Bellows has 1 gold and Tell me was protected. But that was a good play from Sandy's part. Bottom shadow, and from here on out I think Sandy will be able to control exactly which challenges he will win to get himself that 8 militant trigger. For pebbles. He finished marching with 3 gold. Could be again the third true diplomat of infamous Sparrows that I keep talking about. But they will not do much this turn in the fortified position. Let's hope that Devour was enough to get back for. And it will get a little bit further into his game plan. Again, you see Warrior Braid, Marshall, and if Orleans still triggered for gold this turn. And Noble Lineage, again for gold. Hold for draw. This with the Valyrian Steel agenda, we will see a lot of these events, attachments, sorry, I'm thinking about another old agenda designed by the same player, where there will just be a constant econ or constant draw engine and have a minor effect in the game. Henry also found his flip bottom, and let's see how his discard pile looks like. He has only one black market merchant. Unfortunately, his effect is come out of shadow and not come into play. Let's see if Sandy will do any type of challenges here. Stay for defending, holding. You're right, Jack. That yeah, I missed that. That begging would have cancelled the save. I think the Valor was, as you said, bold, but then there were some merits to actually playing it there. Considering that Henry's port was getting a little bit out of control with Sir Baristan Selmy on the board, he would have single-handedly won the game. Sandy used Shadow of the Rose to find unexpected Guile, and then played Fate Decree to prevent Plaza of Pride from triggering this turn. So this way he's trying to either force Henry to let the challenge go, considering he has no claim, or waste a character. expect the game will be pretty drawn out. Considering that, for instance, you need, looks like it needs some time to get a hit or get a full in the game, and Great Militant being stalling deck in score. We see that challenge is defended. Triggering three bottom. Which will diplomat into play, but perfect position. Here, power challenge for three. I think this one can be left on a pause considering that the character is not demonstrated. I wonder now if he will forgo the military and just do power Henry when he comes to his challenges, leaving the board as it is and just getting out from Sandy's hand with the black market merchant. If little board ambushed the agenda and triggering for gold, that's the gold that will be bottom. Or challenge with Hago. Merchant. No hit. If all Billy Bond discarded for him. Dominance was a tie. On next spot, let's see what options are left for both players. We have for Sandy, we have compelled, duel, and return to the field at Sandy's side. So Sandy for next call to return to the field, duel and compelled by the fate. He played compelled by the fate and we have you win or you die for Henry. The other options for Henry were King in the North, you win or you die, or Duferis. It looks like he's trying to just close down the game as fast as possible now in gears. Hold down trigger, gives Sandy a power and character. We found devoted board rider that will prevent gold gain during come in this space. On Henry's side we have Khal Drogo, 5 gold saved for now. Looks like the agenda never let Henry be out of cards, so he was forced to use his Dragon Gate, which is a good news for the archetype. We have Dragon Skull, one of the newer attachments. While there are not Dragon characters in play, attached characters gain Intimidate and Renown. Now Drogo has double Renown. Also that crucial Intimidate. Considering he's going first. What other attachments we can see from the Targaryen side that we still haven't seen? We have Bloody Arak, Drogo's Arak. We don't have Drogo's Arak, which prevented the character to new from the first challenge, but we have Bloody Arak, which will add additional challenge for 1 gold, and the 3 gold that he has left may be a Queen's Guard, one of the other 3 gold characters. Also we can see Silver Steed, which is that will allow him additional power challenge, again grants renown. There is a lot of flexibility with the 3 gold left for the attachments we can see come into play. But I think with now that we have devoted free riders, he will not be able to have free bottom trigger and a 3 gold, but he doesn't have the character at this moment in the card file. But I think he's in a very close distance to go. Also we can see Aegon coming from Shadow with Daryl, which is another renowned character, and stealing one of the devoted free riders to whittle down the board even more. Your military challenge, Drogo and Hago for which we renown. We have Second Sons, Guarded, and Drogo. The old Billy Bone 3 bottom, enough to defend the challenge. Oh, maybe it is enough. Now Sandy has an 11 strength for defense. I wonder if he will put all of them into defense, considering there is a second military challenge coming. Let's just do a quick check to see if there is... Bloody Arak doesn't give strength, right? Currently, I don't think there is a way for Henry to boost his strength further. So I cannot think of a way, considering that the Strangward was used previous turn. we have Milk of the Poppy that will shadow characters only. So the interaction here is that compared to previous edition, shadows is a keyword, and because Old Billy Bone was the keyword due to the milk, the unexpected guile dropped, so he was the strength here. And that's an interaction. You can receive the same result with the nightmares or other blunting effects. Like the nightmares. I think this will allow Henry to pull out the game. Without any significant problems. If Renown and cannot see it, Chicago. So the stuff going on there, the warrior braid, the additional strength, the intrigue icon. Yep, and that was the nail in the coffin, so Sandy conceded the game at this point, and I think he Henry was able, would have been able to close out without a problem from here. We have power on a post and Renown, which is 4 strength, and another military for on a post without a problem. Oh. Thank you guys for watching. And we'll see you later today for another game if I manage to close it. Now I'm going for dinner. I agree with Sandy's statement that with Billbone he maybe had a chance, but although the slow start for Henry, he found all his attachments at the right time. Also, a few misplays from both sides, but I don't think... Yeah, as Henry said, the crown was a gotcha moment, but that's always possible to see. Then guys, good luck in the next round for Sandy, well done for Henry, and see you in the next broadcast. Inception.